back. This is Boomer Life on CIAL 650.
Don't you listen to what the man says.
And you're listening to Boomer Life on CIAL 650. I'm Joanne Sutton. Thanks for joining us today. We're talking about the dramatic effects of hearing loss and the solutions that you can find with Next Gen Hearing. So in studio with me is audiologist Dr. Ted Venema. Also on the line, we have otologists Dr. Brian Westerberg and Dr. Jane Lee, ear, nose, throat specialists in Vancouver, and they're based out of the Rotary BC Hearing and Balance Center at St. Paul's Hospital. So we're going to talk now about sudden hearing loss, and there's actually a terminology for that, is there not?
Most people will gradually lose hearing over the years of their life, probably related to cumulative noise exposure in our society. Some people will come in one day and they'll just suddenly have lost it altogether overnight. Often the story is they'll wake up in the morning and they realize they've got a loud buzzing or humming in their ear and they can't hear anything. So the acronym that we use for that is sudden sensory neural hearing loss. It's much different than the gradual hearing loss that you typically develop as we enjoy life longer.
And what actually is it? It's just literally you can wake up in the morning and you won't be able to hear the radio? You won't be able to hear your husband offering you a coffee? Or?
Typically, yes. It's typically will affect one ear, not two. The other ear is usually still functioning well. What happens is open to speculation. We have a number of theories. One is that it's a virus. You know, some viruses like our nose, some like our stomach, well, some like the ear. So the virus gets in, causes inflammation or damage that manifests itself as hearing loss. Other people may have a blood clot that goes to their ear, so they lose hearing because there's no longer any blood supply to the ear.
What about is it linked to any other diseases or any other conditions?
The one thing that we always worry about but we hardly ever find is there's benign tumors that can also cause sudden hearing loss in the ear. So usually when people have a sudden loss, even if it recovers fully, they should have an MRI scan just to make sure that one of those benign tumors is not there.
Hmm. I've also, just doing a little research for this show today, read some things about possible other, like MS or Lyme disease.
Occasionally, that would be pretty unusual, I think. And usually there's other manifestations than just the hearing loss.
Okay. And so what do you do for SSHL? How is that treated?
So typically it's one of the more emergent type things. So if you do have a sudden loss, the most important thing is that you go to see a health practitioner as soon as possible. We usually like to treat and diagnose these patients within 24 to 48 hours. So it's something you really shouldn't sit on. There's a lot of different things in the literature that can be used for sudden sensory neural loss. Typically, this is believed to be inflammatory or inflammation from most likely a virus is what is thought. So we treat patients with steroids as long as there isn't contraindications to take those, usually treated by mouth. By taking them orally. There are other options in terms of injecting steroids through the eardrum that will then diffuse into the inner ear that can often help as well. And there's a third option that's called hyperbaric oxygen treatment, where patients essentially go into a special chamber, and that's there's some literature to show that that might be beneficial in sudden sensory neural loss. And the final thing is that we do screen those patients with an MRI scan to make sure they don't have one of those benign tumors that Dr. Westerberg was mentioning.
So this SSHL, is it curable? It doesn't mean that it's permanent, that they're never going to get their hearing back, or is that a 50-50?
No, some patients do improve. It's really hard because so many patients come in with, you know, different health conditions. The type and pattern of hearing loss they have is different. Studying this in terms of figuring out how many patients will improve and depending on what treatment they do is quite difficult. It depends the pattern of hearing loss in terms of whether they will improve. So sometimes we have an idea as to whether it's not very likely that they'll improve, but even in those conditions, sometimes we're surprised. I don't think we have a good grasp on which patients do improve, but we do see some dramatic improvements with those treatments.
So is this something that a hearing aid could assist with, or is this a condition that would require surgery?
So most often a hearing aid, if you don't get full recovery, will work quite well with this condition. If you have a sudden loss, usually I think you're going down the cochlear implant route. Some people do have hearing loss that affects both ears. On rare occasions, it can suddenly impact both ears, but usually it's just one with a sudden hearing loss. There's some rare conditions that can cause it to go in both ears. So, you know, in that situation, if you do have hearing loss suddenly in both ears, obviously you haven't had the benefit of a gradual loss where you've learned to lip read or sign or use other cues and develop coping strategies. So other things that are important is also vision. So in people that are visually impaired that have hearing loss, we treat that also as an emergency as well, because their other senses are not there to help them.
I've known someone who had a sudden sensory neural loss, and as she says, it happens one ear. And she woke up in the morning with it, just kind of hearing some popping or buzzing sound, but she could hear the dial tone on her phone. That was about it, because that was kind of a low pitch. But all the other pitches of her hearing were gone. And she didn't get it treated quickly enough, and that's why I'm really glad Dr. Lee mentioned people should see a doctor quickly.
ASAP.
Yes, and usually the treatment is steroids, and sometimes the hearing can be brought back to some degree. Hers never did come back, and but she copes just fine, just has trouble telling the direction of sound, but she can hear fairly well, but a hearing aid for her wouldn't do much good, because there's so much damage to the hair cells that in the mid and higher pitches that she would basically, with a hearing aid, just kind of get boop, 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 you know, a loud boom, 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 but there would really be nothing else. So she took the opting out clause and didn't do that, didn't follow with hearing aids.
But. And I just thought I should add that sometimes people that have sudden hearing loss, it's not always the organ of hearing that's a problem. Some people can have, you know, fluid in the ear, behind the eardrum. And so it's important that someone's looking to rule those out. And also there's specialized tests at the bedside people can do to determine the type of hearing loss. So not all sudden hearing loss is treated with steroids. It does require an examination by a trained practitioner.
Well, Dr. Lee and Dr. Venema, I think you both raised a very good point in the essence that if one of us were to wake up with any type of a hearing loss or experience some difficulty in hearing, I don't think we realize the severity of it.
Get it checked. Just get it checked, because you've got, as you know, you've got the three areas of hearing: the outer, the middle, and the inner ear. And the problem could be, as Dr. Lee says, anywhere, but you're not going to know unless you find out.
Mm-hmm. So if this continues for another day or two, or even three or four, and you're not noticing an improvement,
yeah, you should go in.
And you're hoping it's not too late.
Earlier the better. If it does go, we like to see them within 24 to 48 hours if possible at our clinic, so that requires them to go into, you know, see their family physician or walk into one of the audiology clinics that we have in the city, or go through emergency if they're unsure.
But I think you've hit on an important thing too, Joanne, is that, you know, when you hear hooves, you think horses, not zebras, and there are many things that commonly cause hearing loss in one ear that will fix themselves and or are not an emergency, and those things are far more common than what we're talking about. The problem is that when the assumption is made that it is one of those other things and it's not, by the time we figure that out, it's often too late.
Very good point. Did we happen to mention yet the number of Canadians or those in British Columbia that are suffering hear loss? Do we have any statistics on that?
A lot.
A lot. Hundreds? Are we talking hundreds of thousands? Or?
Well, every year there's, let me see, what is there? Every year there's 40,000 children born in British Columbia. The chance of one of them having a significant hearing loss is about 1 in 1,000. As you develop, as you grow, people will develop hearing loss later in life too. So probably by the time you hit 10 years of age, the frequency, prevalence is more like 1 in 500, 1 in 600 or something like that. So if you take into more mild hearing losses too. It's far more prevalent. As we enjoy life longer, pretty much everybody loses hearing in the high frequencies. It becomes a problem in a minority of those people, obviously.
And that's the most common cause of hearing loss is age. The second most common cause is undue noise exposure.
Mm-hmm.
But hearing loss, I'd say 30% of people over 65 have a significant high-pitched hearing loss. We call it the trouble with treble. They can hear, but they can't hear the sharp consonants of speech. So they hear speech but can't understand what you said. Did you say dishes or fishes? You know? So they're always using the context to figure out what someone did say. Half of people over 75 have that significant hearing loss. And the word for it is presbycusis. And it sounds like Presbyterian, but it's hearing loss in the elders. Presbyterian Church of the Elders.
So. Well, you've heard it here. The trouble with treble. You're listening to Boomer Life on CL 650. I'm Joanne Sutton. Today we're talking about the dramatic effects of hearing loss and the solutions that you can find with Next Gen Hearing. In studio, we're speaking with Next Gen's Dr. Ted Venema, audiologist. And on the line, we have otologists Dr. Brian Westerberg and Dr. Jane Lee, who are ear, nose, and throat specialists in Vancouver. If you want more information, please go to nextgenhearing.com. And I hope that we're answering some of your questions, some of the questions that you might have about hearing loss. We will learn more from our audiologist, Dr. Ted Venema, and our otologist, Dr. Westerberg and Dr. Lee, when we come back. This is Boomer Life on CL 650.
Canada's only weekly radio show dedicated to the baby boomer lifestyle. This is Boomer Life on CL 650.